Dear student, welcome in today's lecture. Today's practical is to study the effect of hypnotics and sedative with the help of one instrument that we call as ectophotometer. So let's start with our today's experiment. The aim of experiment is...
This experiment is to study the effect of hypnotic sedative in mice by ectophotometer method.
Objectives of this experiment are to understand the terms sedation, hypnosis, to understand behavioral profile like awareness, mood and motor activity.
And with this title, we are going to see what do you mean by sedation, what do you mean by hypnosis. Already we have covered this point in hypnotic and sedative chapter, so you can refer it. I am again posting the link in the description box, so use it, that link, for the further information. As well as today, we are going to see some understanding behavioral profile like awareness, mood, and most important thing is motor activity. So for that purpose, the requirement for our today's experiment is, the animal we are going to use is a mouse. And the drug and chemical which is used for this today's experiment is a diazepam. And equipments like syringe, needle, cotton, beaker, ectophotometer is an instrument that could be used for in today's experiment, and weighing balance. So with these requirements, we are going to start with our today's experiment. So in this experiment, first initially we will see what is the theory behind this experiment, and then we will go for the actual practical demonstration of this experiment. So let's start it.
Sedative hypnotic are CNS depressants. Sedative hypnotic, except benzodiazepines, depress the CNS gradually in a dose-dependent manner. Thus, by increasing in dose of sedative hypnotic, calming or drowsiness, that is sedation, sleep or hypnosis, unconsciousness, surgical anesthesia, fetal depression of respiratory and cardiovascular center, followed by coma, is produced. Barbiturates and benzodiazepines act mainly on the midbrain reticular activating system. This region is responsible for maintenance of wakefulness. These drugs also act on the cerebral cortex, cerebellum, pyramidal cells, thalamic relay neurons, and spinal cord. These drugs activate the inhibitory GABA receptors and lead to diminished synaptic transmission, thus produce depression of CNS.
So this is what about a beautiful explanation about the CNS depressant drug, how the CNS depressants are producing its action. As we discussed it earlier, in the same manner, these all CNS hypnotic sedative particularly, they are dose dependent manner. When we start the dose, initially it will produce hypnotic effect, initially it produces the calm down effect, then drowsiness, then may induce the sleep, then may produces unconsciousness. Even may increase the dose, then patient may go for the surgical anesthesia. Even we increase the dose, then there could be a fetal depression of respiratory, followed by the cardiovascular centers, and then the patient will enter in a coma. So this is what the single, as we increase the dose of the drug, there is an increase in this activity, change in the activity. So that's why we call it as it's in a dose dependent manner. The barbiturates and benzodiazepines, they are particularly acting on the midbrain reticular activating system. So what is that midbrain reticular activating system? Midbrain reticular activating system is responsible for maintaining of the wakefulness. So as they are acting particularly on this center, so wakefulness is get disturbed. That we call as a CNS depressant. As well as these drugs are also act on cerebral cortex, cerebellum, pyramidal cells, thalamic relay of neurons, and the spinal cord. Due to that, we could get some fetal depression as well as coma or cardiovascular system. Why? Because all these centers are get involved with the help of the barbiturates, and that's why this barbiturate, if we use more than that of the dose prescribed, then it could be dangerous. As well as the mechanism action of this barbiturate, as it is the same thing that particularly they activate one neurotransmitter that we call as a GABA. So as it activate the GABA, gamma aminobutyric acid, which it binds with its receptor, and due to that increases the opening of the chloride channel and increases the influx of the chloride ions, and thus it diminishes the synaptic transmission. It reduces, it downs, flow downs the transmission, and thus it produces CNS depressant effect. So this is what about this information given about the basic information about the hypnotic sedative and how the barbiturate and other parts are going to be applied, going to be act on a body. The next theory that we will see that
the sedative hypnotic activity can be observed by studies on locomotor activity in mice. Sedative hypnotics affect adversely the locomotor activity in mice and in human beings. The locomotor activity is measured in mice before and after administration of sedative hypnotic employing GAN, an ectophotometer or activity gauge. The ectophotometer consists of photoelectric cells and light source. The photoelectric cells are connected to the counter with an electrical circuit. When a beam of light falls on photoelectric cells in an uninterrupted manner, the electrical circuit is completed and digital counter does not show any reading. When mice are placed on the grid of ectophotometer, the light rays are interrupted due to movement of mice. The light rays do not reach the photoelectric cells, breaking the electrical circuit temporarily. The digital counter now shows interruptions in digits.
So this is what about this information is given in this slide, that is in what manner we are going to conduct the hypnotic sedative activity. So this base of this study is in a locomotor activity. Now what do you mean by this locomotor activity? Locomotor activity is nothing but ability of animal or ability of human being or anything, object, was moving from one object to the another and again takes place in the next stage, that we call as a locomotor activity. So by using this locomotor activity method, we can conclude whether the drugs we are giving for the study are hypnotics or sedative. So what they have did, they use one instrument, that instrument is called as, this instrument we called as an ectophotometer. This instrument we called as an ectophotometer. So in what is the application of this ectophotometer? This ectophotometer is used to check the or measure the locomotor activity. So what we are going to do, we will check before giving a drug hypnotic sedative. Initially we check the locomotor activity in this instrument, then after we administer the hypnotic sedative, and again we will check this locomotor activity in this instrument. And by observing this initial and after administration of hypnotic sedative, what is the difference in a locomotor activity, that we will check. And by checking on this, we can conclude whether that drug is acting as a hypnotic sedative or not. So this is what that instrument is called as ectophotometer, as well as the synonym of this instrument is also called as an activity gauge. It is also called as an activity gauge. So this is an activity gauge or this is an ectophotometer. Now what is the basic principle? That this instrument works? So before starting with this particular description about this ectophotometer, I would like to show one thing, that is this image, you will get more clearance about it. You might have seen in some of the malls or some of the areas where when you come in front of the door opens and you will go out. See, as that lady comes here, so door open. As he is not there anywhere, the door is get closed. Again, see, I am in front of the door. Door is get open and C goes out. So here, this principle is similar with this actophotometer. This principle is similar with this actophotometer. So how does it working? How does it working? What is that? Let's see. This is one of the very wonderful information. I will again explain you once it is get finished. So this actophotometer is consist of. This actophotometer is consist of mainly two cells. One is called as photoelectric cell and another one called as a light source. So these are the two cells. One is photoelectric cell. What do you mean by the photoelectric cell? Photoelectric cell means, this photoelectric cell means, photo means light. Electric means the instrument or the cell which create electricity with the help of light. So as we can call it as a solar. So like in a solar, there are some cells which are get prepared, some electricity with the help of light, that we call as photoelectric cell. And another one is a light source, as a beam of light, it's a simple light source. So these two important cells are present in this actophotometer activity gauge. The photoelectric cell are connected to the counter. Whatever we want to measure the locomotor activity, that we should know, we should get the count, how much times that is going to count. So that is get connected to the counter with an electric circuit. When a beam of light falls on photoelectric cell, beam of light, when it emits a light, it get falls on a photoelectric cell. Suppose this is a photoelectric cell and this is a beam of light. So light starts, this light emits its rays and this rays get fallen on photoelectric cell. So this is an a circuit. This is an a circuit. When the beam of light fall on a photoelectric cell on in an uninterrupted manner, the electric circuit is complete and digital counter does not show any reading. Light rays starts, light rays get falls on this photoelectric cell, connected to the counter. So this circuit is get complete. So as circuit is complete, there is no any count. Right? But when the mice are placed on the grid of actophotometer, there are some grid on, these are the some steel grids are there, and you can see here there are some steel grids. So at that steel grids, electric current is get supply. So as this mice get exposed to electric supply, they start to run from here to there. So as they started to run here from there, they start to break the light. That is nothing but interruption due to movement of the mice, and the light rays do not reach to the photoelectric cell. As the light is not reaches to the photoelectric cell, circuit is break. Due to breaking of this circuit, temporarily there is one count. Circuit is temporarily disconnected and digital counter gives some count. So this is the basic principle. In a same manner, when no one in front of this label, whenever no one is there in front of this door, then this door is get closed now. Now there's lady come, yes, as she came there, immediately door gates open. So this is the principle. What this principle? When someone comes there, there is a breaking of light. Definitely some lights will be there and that light will get interrupted. And due to interruption of these light, that circuit one circuit come complete and door gates open. And as the door gate open, we could feel that due to presence of us or due to when we arrival at there, this doors are gate open. That is the basic principle. The same principle is going to be applied in this instrument. That is called as an actophotometer. So this is what about the basic information about this actophotometer activity gauge. Now let's see how practically we are going to be apply, implement this part. So let's see this.
To study the effect of sedative hypnotic in mice, activity gauge like actophotometer can be used. An actophotometer operates on principle of photoelectric cell. Photoelectric cells are connected in a circuit with a counter. An actophotometer may have a circular or square floor area of metallic rods. Current flows through these rods upon application of voltage, causing movement of the animals inside. Remember, when a beam of light falling on the photocells is cut off by an animal, a count is recorded. Actophotometer is provided with main on-off switch, digital counter, reset button, rotating knob for adjustment of voltage. Now select three adult healthy mice of either sex weighing not less than 20 gram. Place them individually in the actophotometer. Turn on the equipment and note the Bessel score for individual mice for 10 minutes. You can see that when animal moves, a count is recorded on digital counter. Note the reading. Now inject 0.2 ml of diazepam solution intraperitoneally to individual mice. Observe the activity of three individual mice at an interval of 15 minutes up to 1 hour. You will notice that movement of mice has decreased gradually. A state of drowsiness is produced, characterized by suppressed movement. This is recorded in terms of counts, indicating sedative effect is produced without sleep. A further increase in dose, you will notice further depression is induced in CNS and animal enters in a state of deep sleep characterized by abolition of movement. The decreased count indicates depressed central nervous system. Clinically, diazepam-like drugs are used as sedatives, hypnotic, or anxiolytics in insomnia or anxiety, that is hypnosis.
Yes. So in this experiment, what we had seen that totally first initially they explain about this, what is this actophotometer and what is this. So these are the some grids. This is called as grids. These are called as the grids. So these are the steel grids and to whom we are giving some electric current. So as when we place the animal in this grid, the animals start to move here and there because of the electric current. So this is a grid. Again, there are some cells here. You can observe here is a cell. This is a cell. So these are the some cells. So these cells, they are act as an, these are the photoelectric cells, because here light is not there. And opposite to it, here if you see here, if you see these are the light sources. These are the light sources. So as they start to emit the light is get emitted from here and they get fallen on this particularly this part. So as they are started to release, they will fall on here, here and here. Due to that, we can say that this light is get emitted and it is get received by the photoelectric cell. So this is the basic information about this actophotometer, and this is the basic information that on and off button, plug, the counter is there, and the reset button is there. So all these parameters they have mentioned, and after that we place the animal. As we place the animal, this animal started to move from here and there. See, it started to move from here and there. As it started to move from here and there, then some count is get changed here. The sound count is started to change here. This is the main what this interruption of light. These lights are get interrupted by the mice, and due to interruption of this interruption by the mice. Yes, if you see this mice, as this mice is present here, so this light is get interrupted, and this due to this interruption of light, this mice changes from here and there. It started to run from here and there. So this light is get interrupted, and that much count is here we could observe. Next we can see that we will give, this is what first we will give an we will check this first we check the actophotometer activity, acto locomotor activity with the help of actophotometer. Then we administer the drug, and again we check the locomotor activity. And whatever this reading or count we observed, by that we can conclude that the decrease in a count indicate depression of the central nervous system. And clinically, diazepam like drugs are used as sedative, hypnotics or anxiolytics in insomnia or in anxiety. So by this we can conclude how this drug is act as a hypnotics and sedative. This is what about this information. Now next is an observation table. If you see this observation table, then you will get an idea, clear idea about it. So three animals we could use it. So this is a reading that before instillation of hypnotics and sedative, then after we had given drug, and after 0 minute, 15 minutes, 30 minutes and 60 minutes, we check the count. Initially the count is 133, and after 60 minutes it is get at near about 65. Here it's a 132, after 60 minutes it's a 63, 134 it is a 67. So we can say that approximately 50% of activity is get decrease. So that's why we can say that this drug is useful as a, or drug, this drug is act as an hypnotic sedative. This drug is act as an hypnotic sedative. This is the main conclusion. So this is an observation table that we need to write. So in this observation table we can, so this is an observation table, animal 1, animal 2, these are there. So animal A, B, C, before the drug how much is the count, after the drug and how much is the percentage. So likewise you can just put it here. This is animal A, B, C, or 1, 2, 3, 134, 133, 136, this is the count. And if you see here, same before and 1, 2, 3, here you can. So from that we can conclude that, therefore from the observation it is concluded that diazepam produces CNS depressant effect. CNS depressant effect. So this is what about our today's experiment, that is drug acting as a hypnotic sedative with the help of another method that we called as actophotometer. So what is the conclusion?
You have learned that sedation is followed by hypnosis, loss of writing reflex and locomotor activity indicate sedative hypnotic action. Sedative hypnotic produce CNS depression.
So we are compared here two activities. One is writing reflex method and another one is a locomotor activity. In writing reflex also we check that there is a decrease in a writing reflex. And in locomotor activity also, we shows that we get information that it is a loss in a locomotor activity, reduction in a locomotor activity. That's why we can say that these drugs are having hypnotic sedative in action. And sedative hypnotics produces CNS depression. Why this locomotor activity and writing reflex is decreased? Because of the decrease in a CNS performance. That's why there is a decrease in activity. So this is what about our today's experiment. That is, if hypnotic sedative by ectophotometer. By two methods, we seen this effect of hypnotic sedative. One is by writing reflex method, and another one is called as ectophotometer by activity gauge. So this is what about this experiment. So if anything is there, let me know. I would like to clear it as much as possible. Thanks for watching. Thank you.